Hello everyone, thank you for attending today's Process Desk webinar. We will be beginning shortly. Today we have our presenters being Vaibhav, who is our Edge AI software product manager, myself, who is the product marketing engineer, and then Mohammed Fadil as well, who is the AI development engineer. So today's webinar will be over the analytics capabilities of our newly released ARM-based processor, AM62x. You can, when it comes to any questions, you can ask throughout chat, throughout the full webinar. We do have some co-hosts here who can help answer any questions you have throughout the webinar. And we'll have time for questions as well at the end of the webinar. So for today's agenda, we'll be having first an introduction to the AM62x, then an introduction of what TI Analytics is, and then the whole processor portfolio. After that, we'll be having a more technical deep dive on how to enable Edge AI on AM62X. That'll be focusing on specific Edge AI solutions, Edge AI packages, analytic models and performances as well. Finally, we'll be going over our ARM developer ecosystem and then really how to start development on AM62X now. So firstly, just wanted to start off with an introduction of what AM62X is in our TI processor business unit. So the TI processor business unit is split into three different product lines, being Sitara MCU, Sitara MPU, and then also Jacinto. These product lines are divided between ARM-based processors and MCUs, and then also we also have our digital signal processors as well. These pertain to key markets such as industrial, automotive, personal electronics, communication equipment, and also enterprise systems. Next, I wanted to first talk about AM62X, some key values of AM62X and differentiations between other ARM-based processors. So a few things about AM62X family is that it is very power efficient and does not require a heat sink or fan having active power below 2 watts, and it does have a 5-year battery life cycle as well. We do have advanced display features with AM62X as well, being able to support dual display interface and full 2K HD resolution. Thirdly, we're also able to protect privacy with AM62X with our hardware security module, which really protects your design integrity, prevents any type of anti-cloning, and also helps with IP protection. This is a very low-cost MPU for analytics as well. So on the right side, you can see that we have very good ease of use, Edge AI, we have facial and gesture recognition on the ARM, and then we have analytics and vision algorithm as well. AM62X is a very leading low-cost system solution. It has rich on-chip resources and a simplified power solution. So AM62X starting price is at $6, and you can use it to really revolutionize your next generation system and solution. It's available right now on TI.com. You can look at any of the links here highlighted with AM623 or AM625. Nextly, I wanted to flash up the block diagram of AM62 here and showcase some of the key features pertaining to AM62X, especially for analytics. AM62X is a scalable solution of devices here from 1 to 4 A53s. And it does have a 3D graphics engine as well, supporting up to 8 gigaflops. As mentioned earlier, AM62X also has a display subsystem supporting DPI, OLDI, and LVDS as well. And finally, I also wanted to mention some of the safety and security functions of AM62X, that being the hardware security module that has two dedicated Cortex M4Fs that run at 400 megahertz, really providing a security solution for the AM62X. Next, I wanted to really showcase the AM62X family of devices here and show what AM62 devices are and how they are pin-to-pin compatible. On the diagram to the right here, you can see that the family is very scalable, scaling from 1 A53 to 4 A53s, so going from the AM6231 to the AM6254. And then also really having a 3D graphics version and then a version without 3D graphics as well. So AM623 here is scalable from 1 to 4A53 without 3D graphics. And if you do need 3D graphics for your design, we have the AM625, which has 1 to 4A53s as well with the 3D graphics GPU. For the specific Cortex A53, these are also scalable between 800 megahertz, 1 gigahertz, and then also 1.4 gigahertz. Really, again, some key takeaways from the AM62X family is the scalability from 1 to 2 to 4 cores, the extensive low power modes available with AM62X, our secure boot built into the device, customer programmable security, really, with our hardware security module, our dual display capabilities with 2K resolution, our safety and security functions with ASIL-B, and also our advanced and extended temperature grades available from 105 to 125 Celsius. Next, we'll be going over the TI processor ecosystem here, which I can pass off to our Edge AI software product manager, Vaibhav, to really tackle here.
Thank you, Mayur. So today's webinar is about the AM62 device, which is a new addition to the TI's Edge AI device portfolio. As Mahir mentioned, TI's processor portfolio spans a wide spectrum of devices, ranging from the Sitara MCU family, which are real-time high-end microcontrollers. From there, starting on to adding application core processors, which is Cortex A53, and additional DSP cores, taking you all the way to Jacinto family, which is primarily geared towards ADAS and heavy processing applications. We have enabled the Edge AI components for the higher-end devices already, and an offering is available for TDA4, which is a Jacinto family device up to 8 TOPS. With the addition of AM62 device, we add a new ARM-only device to the AI family or supported family of devices. What we bring to you is an A53 ranging from 1 to 4 cores and dedicated accelerators available for application-specific tasks. Essentially, with this device, we are enabling the entire community of ARM ecosystem, whether it is AI-specific modules and ecosystem, or it is specific applications developed by the wider community to be able to be ported to this particular device. Next few slides, we will go through how the Edge AI is enabled for AM62 family, specifically on the A53 cores. But before that, I wanted to give you an overview of what we already have as TI's Edge AI ecosystem, spanning Jacinto as well as Sitara family. So my next slide. As an overview, if you can see from left to right, the power or the performance of the device scales all the way up to 8 TOPS. The left end is AM62 device, which is the focus of today's webinar. The primary processor or the engine for this is the ARM A53 core, ranging from dual to quad core. Various variants are available, as Mahir showed in the slides earlier. But what this allows you to do is the finally wider model set that is available from TensorFlow, PyTorch, ONN. These are the ones that we'll go into more details about. But other than that, a wider variety of third-party ecosystems who have already developed models on these devices can readily be ported onto devices on these variants. And we will look at a few of these in the end. There are a few webinars that are focused towards these applications and models from our third parties. But as you can see, we have a spectrum of performance available with only ARM, an addition of DSP cores, which has a dedicated accelerator for deep learning. We call it as the matrix multiplier accelerator, which can also allow you to get extra performance on dedicated AI models. Today's ecosystem is primarily geared towards vision-based models, but as you can see, because of the wider ARM capabilities we have, you can extend these easily to the models available on audio, predictive maintenance, and if you stay tuned, you will see a variety of these applications available on AM62 device going forward. Here are some of the things that are already available today on TI.com, and if you click on the Azure link below, we will also provide this deck separately on training.ti.com with clickable links. But you can see you have an entire range of tools. Some of them are cloud tools where you can upload your own model, explore the performance of the models on our devices. We will soon be adding more devices, including the AM62 to that portfolio. You can look at an extensive library of models available from TI. You can also upload your own and see the performance for any of those. It will also let you compare which model suits and runs as per the needs of your application and select that and quickly deploy it on TI system. Finally, we have an ecosystem of boards available along with the TDA4. The AM62SK board are today available to purchase. We have a variety of third parties whose system on modules can also be used as part of the model ecosystem that we have, and along with the wider software offering that is available here. This is a slide that we will be going more details into as to what all models are available for this device. So I'm quickly going to go to the next section, which is going to be handled by our AI expert Fadil. So I'll hand it over to him. Fadil.
Myself, Fadil Mohammed, and I'm working as an AI development engineer, mostly on the OSRT side of TensorFlow and the ONNet runtime. And today, I'll be talking about various applications and examples where AM62x devices can be put to use, considering its low cost and lower power consumption for the next couple of minutes. So coming to the various application, considering the performance numbers which we got from running various models on AM62, we believe AM62x devices can be put into deployment in scenarios like gesture control for automating some industrial manufacturing process or controlling the infotainment system inside your car. And face recognition can be used to authenticate person and to enable the touchless access control. People detection models on the AM62 will come to use for monitoring the drivers for doziness during the driving sessions and to identify person at your doorbell using the video doorbell systems. Also, an object detection models can be deployed in an AM62 EV on AM62 in an EV charging station to automate the payment of the EV charging cost through number plate detection or the registration plate detection by the AM62 device. All this application, which I explained earlier, can be enabled using the TI's complete and easy-to-use software solution. This TI's software solution is scalable across both Jacinto series as well as the Sitara MPU Cortex A series of chipsets. TI's software comprises of two parts, the one on the left and the one on the right. The one on the left is the model preparation, which consists of the model compilation, fine-tuning of the model, model selection, which is to be all this which need to be carried out on the carried out offline. By offline, I mean it meant to be carried out on the host machine. And on the right side, which is the model inference, which will be carried out happen to be carried out on the target devices. Taking a little bit deep dive into the left side of the part, the model preparation part, customers come to TI with a particular requirement for their ideas or their models. So some customers do have their models ready in their hand and some have to choose the right model from their for their application. In case of customers having does not have the right model, the TI's model maker which is the first bar on the left side, is an end-to-end model development tool, which helps the customers to choose the best model for their use cases. Furthermore, model maker is capable of data preparation, model selection, and model tuning, and model compilation also. In a nutshell, we can see it is a powerful tool to start your development with, and you can start the development using the model maker if you have the if you don't have a model right in your hand. But with the customers who probably know which model they want to run and want to run on the TI's edge AI solutions, they can come and bring their own model. In case of that, TI uses the standard runtime APIs offered by the open source runtimes like TensorFlow Lite or NNX runtime and the TVM for compilation of this model using the standard API, so nothing is deviating from the industry standards. Model compilation will internally make use of TI's model import and model code generation tools, which will take care of the model parsing, model optimizer, and post-training quantization, etc., which is all hidden under the APIs of open source runtimes. This internal model import and code generation will make sure that it will deliver the best performance on the target of every edge AI device, or whether it is just indoor device or it's an AM62 device. In case of TI SoCs having the deep learning accelerators, the TI DSPs or the MMA, model compilation is required for all the runtimes, if it's ONNX or TensorFlow or TVM. But since in case of AM62, which doesn't have the deep learning accelerators, the DLAs, model compilation is only required for the TVM models. Coming to the second part of the TI software, which is on the right hand side, which will be take care of the inference on the edge AI device, TI make use of the industry standard runtime APIs on top of the Linux to generate the best performance per watt on edge AI devices, just indoor as well as the AM62 series. In case of device having the deep learning accelerators, faster speed is achieved by offloading some of the process to the DLA, as you can see in the DLA has been grayed out to show whether it's available or not available, depending on the device. Coming to the next slide. Coming to the SDK release of AM62, some of the features has been enabled in the current release. And the current release can be found in the below link or marked in the red, and the latest release is 8.3.0. So in the latest release of AM62 SDK, we have enabled TensorFlow Lite 2.8 version for the Python API as well as the C++ APIs. We have also validated the HNN as well as the ARMNN delegate options on the AM62. For the ONNX runtime, we have enabled 1.7 in the current SDK. And we have also for the Python as well as the C++ API, and we have validated the default CPU execution provider delegate option. Coming to the feature of AM62 SDK, I want to point out one more thing is that development, the new SDK is support onboard development and debugging of both Python and C++ application for the faster development time and to avoid switching between the development time switching between the workstation and the target device. So here it saves a lot of time during the development time so that the engineer can work on the target device, the AM62 itself, and change on the model and do whatever changes required for the C++ as well as the Python application. As C++ application requests compilation, it is already supported on the AM62 device natively. Also, for in considering the deployment scenarios, we support cross compilation of the C++ application and the models so that the customer can bypass connecting to AM62 devices to workstations for quicker rolling out of the updates. So both of these cross compilation and native compilation has been supported on AM62 in the current release, and everyone can check it out. Coming to the edge AI TIDL tools, it's a repository hosted in GitHub, publicly available for everyone, and it points out few out of the box model examples for based on vision CNN models. This repository can be used as a starting point for your development and benchmarking the performance on the EVM as well as the starter kit available on the market for AM62 as well as the Agisinta 7. Before going into just brief about the Agile Tools repo, I want to just mention that both this repository is common for both Agisinta 7 as well as the AM62. Let me just go into the session. 1 second. Here I need to switch. So this is the publicly available Agile Tools tool repo. As I was mentioning earlier, it can just it's well documented and anyone can easily go through, and it's a setup process is very simple, just like running one setup.sh. Coming to the table, this table pretty much summarizes all the compilation options, all the examples which I was talking about. And as you can see, the TensorFlow and ONNX runtime on both CPP as well as the Python has been validated and ran on the AM62. And on the Jacinto application, almost all the examples have been validated. In the coming releases, we will be updating further examples and validating on the AM62 as well. As I was mentioning earlier, the compilation can be done on target for the CPP application. I'll just brief through that too. Coming to the CPP application here, this table can be used as a compilation for on whether to select an on-device compilation or a cross-compilation based on your device. So if you're compiling on a host CPU based on whether it's an x86 or ARM or a target CPU and a target device being varying from AM62 and a Jacinto 7, you can select the correct row and select the correct compilation option. And based on this compilation option, you will be compiling either on the native compilation or the cross-compilation. Again, coming back to the presentation. Here we have some performance data on AM62. For few models spanning across this semantic segmentation, which is the Deep Lab V3, and object detection, which is SST mobile net, and then classification model on mobile net. So, from our analysis of the data points on these ONNX runtimes and the TF Lite runtime, we have concluded that ONNX TensorFlow Lite 2.8 give a slightly better performance over the ONNX as you for a same model. As you can see on the last one, the MobileNet V1 on the MobileNet V1 on the left side and the right side, which is on the ONNX, both have been the same model. The TensorFlow Lite give a better performance, slightly 105 milliseconds over the 198 milliseconds. Also, since AM62 is available in different configuration like 1, 2, and 4 cores of ARM, a relative gain in performance time has been observed when we utilize all 4 cores. The colors bar depict the performance while using the 4, 2, and 1 cores each. Here, the gray bar depicts the four core utilization, and the orange bar depicts the 2 core utilization, and the blue one depicts the one core. And you can see there is a considerable gain in utilizing the 4 cores, both in ONNX as well as the TensorFlow Lite. Okay, coming to a few more data points. Since TensorFlow Lite supports quantization models, we also took few of the data points over the quantized model on AM62 as well. And here in this graph, the blue depicts the latency in milliseconds for the quantized model, and the green depicts the latency or in millisecond for the float models. Considering your application, whatever your use cases, if your accuracy requirement has been satisfied by the quantized model, we recommend to use the quantized model over the float model. As you can see, there is a huge performance improvement in case of SST MobileNet V2 and a slight improvement in case of MobileNet V2. So, stressing on the point that accuracy requirement is satisfied for your use case, we recommend you to use the quantized model, and we have tried out the AM62, the quantized model on AM62 as well. Another data point, as I mentioned, we have validated the ARMNN as well as the HNN delegate option on TensorFlow Lite 2.8. They have a data point on the SST MobileNet V2 as well as the MobileNet V1 on ARMNN, which is the blue bar, as well as the HNN pack on the green bar. As you can see, the float models, we have observed better performance in ARM and in some of the case like models like MobileNet V2, but not so much performance difference in case of MobileNet V1. I would recommend you to try your own model on with the both delegate option ARM and HNN, as it is an standard API from the TensorFlow Lite. It won't be much hard to switch between these two delegates and find out which one is better, and you can stick on to the better delegate option for your model. Coming to the last part, TI have hosted a public repo for Model Zoo, from where the customers can find the best model suitable for their application. This Model Zoo is common across all the edge AI processes, saying the Jacinto as well as the AM62. Model Zoo hosts more than 100 plus CNN models, mostly based on the camera inputs. And we also have a list of validated models for AM62 as well as the Jacinto 7. You can check it out in the lower link. Before going into the Model Zoo and just brief about the Model Zoo repository, I would like to say that customer can start from the choosing model from the available Model Zoo as a starting point for their application, because as it is being already validated on our device, it will be, there is a very less chance for failure and we'll be able to support very easily. So now, getting a brief about the Model Zoo, just a second with it load. Based on your application, this Model Zoo is well documented, and based on your application, you can choose whether the image, what model you want to will be best for your case. So if it's an image classification model, or whether it's an object detection or face detection or semantic segmentation, depth estimation, everything has been classified and been validated. All these models in the Model Zoo has been validated on either of the device and been hosted on this public repo, and anyone can make use of these models. Coming back. Yeah, I guess, thank you. Thank you all. That's from my side.
Okay. I think the next few slides, we will be going through the available ecosystem components for AM62 device, more specifically geared towards some of the example implementations which are possible today and available for users to download and evaluate using the AM62 SK starter kit. If you look at the TI product page for AM62, there are a variety of ways to reach these resources, including the software and third-party hardware, which is available for the AM62 device. Under the device's design and development page, we have a variety of third parties that are available and developing software on top of our either SK kits or third-party vendor software. And some of these we will click and open, show you what is available today. But we have a few example software examples, which are face recognition and people detection from two of our third parties. And these are ARM ecosystem based examples that are today launched and available. These were also demonstrated at the Embedded World, which happened a few weeks ago. And there was great response from variety of users based on the demos that we had showed there. Another way to reach out to the resources is through AM62 Design Gallery page. You will find your examples, which are ready to download and evaluate on the SK kit. As you can see, the two from a third party are already listed over here. If you keep going, there are a variety of other examples available that will let you see other various features that are available on the device. But the top two are geared towards edge AI software. These are geared towards applications that may primarily use indoor security, surveillance, very robust examples and implementations that are ready to try. Along with touchless access systems, whether it is face recognition to identify and authenticate a person from a database, or HMI touchless interaction, which can be implemented using, in this particular case, radar gestures. There are other examples which are coming up for camera-based gestures only. And these are all going to be ready to use and download and ready to use from the TI's third-party ecosystem. Go back. Again, the links for all of these pages that we showed will be available as part of the slide deck that we will put on training.ti.com. It will be part of the processor's monthly series. To the right here, we can see a variety of system on module. These are hardware manufacturers that have ready-to-use designs and SOMs available, somewhere around 3 centimeters to 4 centimeter area. These can all run the examples that we have here in most of the cases. So that will let you see the smallest form factor available. Each of them have different capabilities and different peripherals brought out. The links are available on this particular slide, but they can also be reached through the design and development tab. And more of those will be added going forward. A quick look at the two examples that we have today to evaluate. First one is touchless access system, which recognizes, detects the faces from the camera, recognizes them, tries to map them against the database. These can be used in a variety of applications, whether entry systems, whether accessing or using equipment. These are available today to download and try. There are various levels of evaluation available. We have a specific webinar planned with more details of the implementation, various blocks, and areas where this application can be readily implemented. Please do sign up. We will show the link later in the slide. Please do sign up for these webinars. Another such example is from one more third party that we have, again, ready to download and use from the links provided here, a very robust people detection model that runs around 20 frames per second on a single ARM core that essentially allows the rest of the cores to be available for other application-specific needs. This essentially shows the various ARM-based models that are available today and can be readily ported to the AM62 device. The way we do this and enable this is through the extensive TI-DL libraries that Fadil talked about. These essentially allow you to bring your own models as long as you're using the standard delegates provided by these models. These can easily be run on any of our devices, including the AM62, which is run most of the delegates on the ARM device itself. Again, for this particular example, we have another dedicated webinar planned. The same link that we talked about earlier can help you sign up for this. We will make the presentations for each one of them and the recordings available offline through the training.ti.com portal.
So the question now is, after this presentation, is how can you really start with AM62x now? How can you start development and really begin with it? So this slide really here showcases getting started with AM62x. So on the right side, you can see the AM62x starter kit. And really on the left side, you can see here the links to different pages where you can find more information on AM62. The first two pages here are the project pages for AM623 and AM625. And as covered earlier, AM625 is the AM62 version that does have the graphics acceleration. So you can go on these pages, click on them, find more information about AM62X. And then we also have application examples available that Vaibhav was showing earlier with the AM62X design gallery. When it comes to specific hardware to start development right now, the hardware itself, the starter kit, is available on TI.com. You can go on TI.com by clicking this link and order an AM62X starter kit. right now and get it in the next few days to start development. Again, these starter kits are available now, and we have software and support as well for AM62X. We have the SDK available. We have our development portal, and we also have our TI Edge AI portal where you can also do testing and development as well. And finally, when it comes to support, we do have dedicated support from real engineers on our E2E forums. So if you have any questions regarding AM62X or any TI processors or any TI questions in general, you can go straight onto these E2E forums and ask questions, and you'll have real engineers answering those questions. So all of these links here are hyperlinks right now, but these slides will be uploaded on training.ti.com, where you can go through, download the slides, and really click on any of these links to go directly to these landing pages. And next slide here, we have